Welcome back to another teaching module in economics. We have just begun with Unit 1, Introduction to Economics and Theory of Consumer Behavior. We have completed the first part of the unit, which is Introduction to Economics, and we are now going on to the second part, which is Theory of Consumer Behavior. This chapter has two aspects to it. First, we will study about a concept called utility, and later on, in the next video, I will cover up indifference curve analysis. So in this video, we will move on towards the study of utility as a part of consumer behavior. Well, it's very important to go into the consumer's mindset and to understand what attracts a consumer. How does a consumer consume? How much needs to be packed into a package of, say, biscuits or a chocolate box? Or any other consumer good. So we need to study, because producers need to know how much they need to provide for an individual consumer or a group of consumers in a package of a particular good. Or there are many other applications to this as well. This is just one example I'm giving you. So let us go on to the next slide. In this module, we will study the concept of utility. We will understand what is total utility and marginal utility. We will study the law of diminishing marginal utility. What is utility? Well, as you can see here, there are three pictures, one with fruits, vegetables, the other with pastries, and the third one with chocolates. Well, these are just examples for you of goods that have utility for us. Why do I say utility? Because all these goods have the capacity to satisfy our wants. So what is utility? Utility is the want-satisfying capacity of a good. The next concept is, what is total utility? Let us first define it. Total utility is the total satisfaction derived from consumption of all units of a commodity. So if I am studying the consumption pattern or the utility derived from, say for example, a pack of Tic Tac, let me see how much a consumer can consume and what is the satisfaction he derives from each unit as he consumes more and more of the units of the commodity. In this case, the example that I've taken is Tic Tac. So say for example, I consume one unit of Tic Tac, I say I derive a utility of 10 utils. You can see I'm assigning a value to express how much satisfaction I derive from consumption of this good. And the unit that I assign it is called as utils. So just as we have express weight in terms of kg or length in terms of centimeters or meters, we express utility in terms of utils. So I say after consumption of one unit of the commodity, I derive a satisfaction of 10 utils. I express it in terms of a numerical value or a cardinal value is assigned to it. When I consume two units, I derive a total satisfaction from the consumption of both units as to be 18 utils. After the third unit of consumption, I derive a total satisfaction from all the three units of 23 utils. After the fourth, I say that I derive a consumption satisfaction of 25 utils, total utility being 25 utils. Then after the fifth unit, I say I still get a satisfaction of 25 utils. And after the sixth one, I actually show that I'm wanting to consume less of it by expressing that the total utility has now decreased from 25 to 23 utils. This table I can call as the total utility table or total utility schedule. So another word for table would be schedule. I translate this table or schedule into a diagram. So here in the diagram, I put units of consumption in the x-axis and total utility on the y-axis. When you draw the diagram on the book, I want you to also add 1 here, 2, 3 here in the middle, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. So we see when the consumer consumes 1 unit, the total utility is 10 utils. When the consumer consumes the second unit, the total utility goes up to 18. When the consumer consumes third unit, the total utility goes up to 23. So you'll have to look this side to plot your point. When the fourth unit is consumed, the total utility derived is 25. As well as the fifth unit gives you the same level of satisfaction, that is 25. So you have the same level here, 25. At the sixth unit of consumption, the total utility falls from 25 to 23. So you'll have to look this side to the left to plot this point. When we join all these points, all these coordinates, when we join, we derive the total utility curve. Let us now move on to the next slide. Now we have the next concept, which is marginal utility. What is marginal utility? Marginal utility is the addition to the total utility as a result of consumption of an additional unit of a good. Here we have the marginal utility schedule. As we see, marginal utility is related to total utility, and let me show you how. When I consume 1 unit of the good, I get a total utility of 10 utils. What is the change from 0? From 0 to 10, the change is 10 utils. When I consume 2 units of the commodity, the total utility increases to 18 from 10. What is the change or difference or addition? The addition is 8 utils. That how do we derive that? 18 minus 10. 18 minus 10 is 8. Then when you consume the third unit, you get a total utility of 23. 23 minus 18 is 5. After consumption of the fourth unit, the total utility is seen to increase from 23 to 25. What is the increase? The increase is 2. How do we know that? 25 minus 23. After the fifth unit of consumption, the total utility does not change. And the fact that it doesn't change is shown by marginal utility coming to 0. That means 25 minus 25 is 0. After the sixth unit of consumption, the total utility decreases. And so we see marginal utility becomes negative. How do we get this negative 2? 23 minus 25. We take the sign of the bigger number. And so we get negative 2. So you see, as you consume more of a good, the marginal utility goes on decreasing. However, the total utility is shown to be increasing. But at what rate is it increasing? It is increasing at a diminishing rate or a decreasing rate. We translate this table, wherein we take the first column and the third column only to draw this diagram. We translate the schedule into a marginal utility diagram and we draw the curve. How do we draw the curve? We plot these points, units of consumption versus marginal utility. As you can see, units of commodity is on the x-axis, marginal utility on the y-axis. So at the first unit, the marginal utility is 10. At the second unit, the marginal utility is 8. At the third unit, the marginal utility is 5. At the fourth unit, the marginal utility is 2. At the fifth unit, marginal utility is 0. So we see the point touching the x-axis. And at the sixth unit, it goes into the negative quadrant at negative 2. When we join all these points, we get the marginal utility curve. So this behavior of a consumer, wherein the consumer consumes more and more units of a commodity, and as he consumes more, he seems to want less of it. So if I go on eating Tic Tacs, for example, in the example that I took, I will continue having them till at a point I will feel like I really don't want to have more of it. And so as I consume more and more of it, I want to have less of the good. So we can generalize this behavior for all consumers. So often it happens, right? How many ice creams can we eat, for example? So you go for one and then you go for another. And then as you go for the third and fourth unit of the ice cream, you seem to want less of it because you're full, kind of, after consuming that product or that commodity. You can apply this to any other consumption good. So let me state the law of diminishing marginal utility. The reason we put it in quote unquote is because it is a statement of the law. So every law has a statement. So here it is. The statement of the law of diminishing marginal utility is, as more and more units of a commodity are consumed, the marginal utility derived from every additional unit must decline. We will try to understand it in the next slide. After the statement of the law, always we have the law based on some assumptions. So, for the law to hold good, or for the law to be true, we assume that the following conditions exist and remain constant or the same. That means these conditions, these assumptions do not change in the time frame of our study. Let us move on to the next. The first assumption is all units must be identical in size, quantity and quality. So you have on the right side three different flavors of ice cream. That won't do, because if we are going to study and conduct an experiment, all the units of the commodity have to be identical in all respects. Then only we can say that this law will be true. Let us move on to the next slide. The second assumption is successive consumption. We assume that units of a good are consumed one after the other in the same time period. Not one unit today and another tomorrow, but continuously. So in the time period of our study, all the units of the commodity have to be consumed successively, or in other words, one after the other. Let's go on to the next slide. The other two assumptions are tastes and preferences must remain constant. We must not change our tastes and preferences suddenly during the period of our study and say, okay, if you are studying strawberry ice creams, I don't suddenly say, look here, I don't like strawberry now, I want to try mango or vanilla or chocolate. No, in this time frame of our study, tastes and preferences must remain constant. The fourth assumption, income also remains constant or the same. It doesn't change. Let's go on to the next. Here we have again the marginal utility schedule and diagram. So when you're explaining the law of diminishing marginal utility, the first thing you need to do is give the statement, which we have done, then state the assumptions, and then draw the marginal utility schedule and express this schedule in the form of a diagram showing the marginal utility curve. So let me go through this again for you to revise it a bit. So we go through 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 units of consumption. The total utility derived from each of them respectively is 10, 18, 23, 25, 25 and 23. Marginal utility is nothing but the difference between the total utility at one level and the total utility at the previous level. So you can express this even in the form of a formula. So if I say, what is marginal utility after consumption of second unit? It is total utility at second unit minus total utility at first unit. I generalize it in the form of a formula. So I say total utility n minus total utility n minus 1. What is n minus 1 in this example? 2 minus 1, which is 1. So TU 2 minus TU 1. What is TU 2? 18. What is TU 1? 10. TU 2 minus TU 1 is 18 minus 10, that is 8. Similarly, we find out for the rest of the table. And to plot this diagram that you see here on the right, we consider the first column and the third column. So when you're explaining the law of diminishing marginal utility, consider that you're drawing the diagram considering the first column and the marginal utility column. You plot points and then you join the points, you will get the marginal utility curve. So therefore, in this module, we have studied the following. We learnt about the concept of utility, total utility and marginal utility, the law of diminishing marginal utility, its statement, the assumptions of the law, the marginal utility schedule, and the marginal utility.